Many people ask me, can you get a decent 3D printer for under $300? Not only can you get a decent 3D printer, you can get a whole starter kit for under $300, including a decent 3D printer, a 3D printing toolkit that has all the tools I recommend you need for 3D printing. It also comes with wrenches and Allen wrenches and extra parts to put your machine together or fix it in case it ever breaks. Also included is Capricorn tubing plus new coupling so you can make your hot end flow even better and work at a higher temperature. Included are nozzles of all sizes so you can print real tiny miniatures or larger vases or just replace the nozzle if it ever wears out. Also included are two different types of filaments, PLA or flexible, to print things on your printer to make it work even better. Also included is software to design your own 3D prints, software to convert those prints into G-code for the 3D printer, and also profiles so you can get good prints from that software right out of the box. You can get all that and still not spend $300. Want to see how to do it? Stay tuned right here at Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. Before I get into this, if you're totally new to 3D printing, I highly suggest you check out my Getting Started with 3D Printing video. I'll link to it up here and also in the description below. It should help you understand all the basics of 3D printing. For my starter kit, I'm using an Ender 3 from Creality. The Ender 3 3D printer comes as a kit just like this. This is it fully assembled. It takes you about 45 minutes to put this together. A lot of the tough stuff is already done. It's just bolting things together. But when you're done, you'll have a better understanding of how your 3D printer works. So I think it's great to start with a kit, at least this simple kit, nothing super complicated. That way you can get printing within an hour and you understand how your 3D printer works. Now this particular unit is from banggood.com, but you can buy this printer from Amazon, you can buy it from matterhackers.com, you can buy it direct from Creality. The difference is you're going to pay a different price. Right now, Banggood, until the 30th of the month, they have a sale going on, $169.99. And that's allowed me to put together a starter package well under $300. Now you can get this same printer from Amazon for about $229. You can get it from Matter Hackers for about that same price, maybe $219. Or you can get it from directly from Creality for about $200. But what I like about this is they have a US warehouse. They also have other warehouses. Banggood, I buy a lot of electronics through them. They're very reliable, but they have a New Jersey warehouse. So I got this machine in 3 days. It cost me $169.99 plus $11.50 shipping. So that's still a heck of a deal and well under $300, and allows me room to make up the rest of the starter kit. The Ender 3 does come with a few tools to put it together and also tools to replace the nozzle or fix little things. So it's a good little toolkit to include. Plus, they give you a few extra parts, like one extra nozzle, a few extra couplings, and they also give you a very small sample of filament to get you started, but it's not nearly enough to print anything. So that's why in the starter kit, I recommend you get your own filament. For filament, I recommend two types of filament, PLA and semi-flex. This is our Filament Friday filament PLA. It prints really easy. This happens to be red, but there's black, there's white, there's different colors. It prints really easy. It's a very low temperature PLA, so it's very good for a beginner to get your first prints to flow nicely and stick to the bed. There's other PLAs out there. You can certainly try all different brands, but at least get one spool of PLA. This guy will cost you $22.99 on Amazon, and this flexible stuff from Cellutech Semi-Flex will cost you about the same, $22.99. So there's about $46 added to the starter kit just from these, but this will allow you to print things and improve your 3D printer. Also included in the starter kit is my Filament Friday toolkit. These are the tools that I've collected over the years that I recommend someone getting started with 3D printing should have in their shop. I'm not gonna go through every tool, but it comes in a nice zipped up bag. And there's just a couple I wanna point out that I really, really like. One, brass brush for cleaning the nozzle. I use this all the time. Another one, a deburring tool or finishing tool, whatever you want to call it. It's got a pivoting head. It's great for cleaning off the edges of a print or inside of holes because it does pivot and cleans out really nicely. It's got hobbyist blades and a cutting mat. Works really well. And also a digital caliper. I use these all the time. In fact, I've used them in some of my videos. And then there's pliers and side cutters and several other tools that I recommend. So this kit sells for $39.99 on Amazon. So with this included, we're still not over $300. A piece of the starter kit are replacement nozzles, and you can get a full set from 0.2 up to 1 millimeter, which is a great range. Now it comes with 0.4 on the Ender 3 and it comes with one extra, but you will go through nozzles. And there's times you want to put a small one on if you're doing really fine detail. And a 1 millimeter nozzle is great for printing something big that you don't need real detail, but you want it to print faster. So this is great to have. Now what I did is I 3D printed a case. So I have a drawer for each size and it works great to store my nozzles, but it does come in a little case. And this is a great addition. So this adds another, I think, $9 to the starter kit. Still not over $300. This next piece of the starter kit is actually an upgrade. The PTFE tubing that comes on the Creality machines has in the past crept up because the coupling didn't hold it tight enough to the nozzle. If you get any gap between the PTFE tube and the nozzle, you can get blockage. So what happens if you put this on with the better couplings, which have the metal fingers, it's going to lock down. Plus, this is a higher temp resistant PTFE, so it lasts longer. So this is really an upgrade to make your printer better and you get a more constant flow. You get about two or three replacements out of the amount of PTFE that's in here, plus the couplings, and you get a cutter to cut the stuff, which is very, very handy. You get a nice clean cut. So this is really an upgrade piece, but I highly recommend it. And it's like $15, $14.99. So with this, we're still not over $300. Now let's talk about software. There is an SD card that comes with the Ender 3. It has a sample print and also has a Cura slicer on it. But I recommend you just go to the Cura website, the Ultimaker Cura website, and download version 4.0 or later. I do have my own profiles that I share for free. I'll put a link to that in the description below. You import those profiles into Cura, use those to slice your files, and you'll get really good prints right out of the box with this printer. Now you also need to level a bed. That's a very important step before you get your first print. I have a video on that that covers how to level the bed on an Ender 3. I'll put a link to that in the description below as well. Now, if you want to design your own 3D prints, I've also got some videos about Tinkercad. Tinkercad is a free design software that's in the cloud. You just go to tinkercad.com, sign up for an account, and you can design anything you want, export it as a .stl, bring it into the Cura software, convert it into G-code, load it on the SD card, and you can print it. All this software, even my profiles, they're all included and available for free. So it adds nothing to the $300 price, but it gives you everything you need to get started 3D printing. With the PLA, you can now make this side spool converter bracket. I share the file on Thingiverse so you can download it, slice it, and print it out. And then once you have that, you can install it on your machine. So the first thing you need to do is remove the spool holder that you use to print that bracket, and then you mount it to the side spool holder. First, you drop in the T-nuts. These are the same T-nuts that you used before on the rail, and it should line right up, and then you use the same screws and put it the bracket into this angled bracket. So just flip it over and tighten them really tight. Once you get those tight, this thing should slide right into the 2020 rail. So just take the back little cover off, which just pries off, it snaps in place. And then you slide on the side spool holder, slides right into the rail. And then you put the black cover back on. Just like I said, pushes and snaps in place. Now you can put on a spool and feed the spool in straight into the extruder, and you're ready to go. With the flexible material, you can now print the Ender 3 rubber feet. These from C3D Miguel on Thingiverse work really well. There's different ones out there if you want to try something different. But you print out four of them, and I just used a standard profile to print these, so they came out pretty good. They're a little bit stiff, but you wiggle them and put them into place, into the rails, and now you've got 4 feet, so make it easier to remove the SD card or install it. There you have it, a complete starter kit for under $300. Everything you need to get started and more. There's one more upgrade that I highly recommend for your Ender 3, and that is the Creality 1.1.5 silent board. I had hoped that Creality would start putting these in the machines by now because this is a great addition to your Ender 3. It's got silent drivers, which makes the stepper motors really quiet. It's got thermal runaway protection for safety, and it's got a bootloader, so it's easy to update the firmware. Now this will add another $46 to $50 to your budget. So maybe you buy this instead of the Capricorn tubing or the nozzles, but this is something I highly recommend. Maybe by the time you've watched this video, they started putting these in the machine. So that's why I've kept it as separate, but I highly recommend this. I have a video on how to install this. I had one of the early boards. I showed how to install it just by swapping connectors. It's pretty easy. This is something you should consider adding to your Ender 3 order.